what's up, guys? Welcome. This is Bleach Streaks. Welcome to the Virtual Voices Podcast. Yo, we're about to go check out my boy, the DJ, and also the freestyler, Chris. Yo, we gotta go check him out. Yo, he's right there. Hey, Chris. I'm sorry if we went to your studio. Yo, I got a question. Yo.
Yo, what's up?
Would you be down to do a podcast with me?
Yeah, for sure.
All right, for sure. Got time though? You got time? Like, you got a minute?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
for sure. All right. Hey, Chris, you coming or what? Chris, you're coming or what, bro? I'm ready to get out of here, my boy. Hey, yo, so we're here at the Virtual Voices Podcast, you know, my personal own, definitely a welcome stay if you guys ever want to check a visit out. Yo, are you ready for these questions?
Let's fucking go.
Okay, so real quick, tell me about yourself. Tell me about yourself, bro. All
right, so I'm Chris. I'm 23 years old. I've been DJing in IRL for 5 years and almost a year going on in VRC here in the VRC DJing scene.
Oh, dang.
So,
it's sick as hell.
I'm a dancer. I'm self-taught. I've only been dancing for a year.
Sheesh.
A hobby of mine. It's just something to do while, because I'm bored. Because I have ADHD, so I always have to be doing something. So dancing and like music, it helps me, get rid of the urge, that stress
and everything.
That's stress.
I feel that. I 100% feel that. Whenever you need to get some toxicity out of your mind or something in your mind where like you need to get it out, that's fucking sick, dude. How long you been doing a VR chat for, or been in VR chat for?
So I've been in VR chat for almost 2 years now.
Oh, dang. Okay.
So, yeah.
Let's run it.
Well, I mean, I started, VRC, just for the hell of it, because, I've been seeing on YouTube videos, all the memes are popping out of VRC, so I decided to buy myself a VR headset,
downloaded it,
just started playing, and I found out that people were dancing in VRC, with full body. See, I was only half body at the time.
Oh, hell yeah.
So I was like, yo, that's fucking sick. I was like, I didn't know how to dance. I didn't know how to dance at all. I mean, most people start out with the shuffle, right? They shuffle
dance. Yeah,
100%. So that's usually how it starts, But me, on the other hand, I saw this group called IDA, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And, they're all breakdancers, like all b-boys, they like to do the spinny flips and shit.
The spinny flips.
The acrobatic moves.
The wha-bams and flaps and wow.
Like, yo, I want to do that shit. I was like,
can you show us one? Can you show one, bro? Can you do one? You being a DJ, have you ever thought of becoming a DJ? Like, what was that mentality of yours?
I wrote DJ 5 years, right?
But oh, just, yeah, my bad.
Just me messing around, me just uploading stuff on SoundCloud and whatnot, just here and there. Just messing around, doing mixes or, custom tracks that I've been making on FL, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so that's just something I like to do, just music, And then dancing, that was just me wanting to do something, just wanted to try it. And we're like, I thought that was cool. I was like, I want to try it, And I wasn't trying to make anything of it, just fun.
Yeah, 100%.
And so what brought on me DJing in VRC was a buddy of mine, Eric Z. He was starting up, he's a world creator and also an art creator, and he's the one that made Resonance Room.
Oh.
Which people have been calling it the ghost club of the U.S. That's what people have been calling it. And, I told him, I was like, yo, I could DJ too. He's like, I've been doing it for a while. Can you bring me on the first show? He was like, yeah. And so the first show, it was the lineup. It was me, Paul Martin, which is another big DJ in the scene.
Oh yeah, 100%.
Gravekeeper and a couple of other DJs, and that was my first time DJing in VRC, and you know, during this time, you know, COVID has just happened, you know. Yeah. You can't go to raves, you can't go to any of that stuff, right? So VR was the closest way that we can, you know, bridge that gap of being able to go to a live show again, because once again you're there in a room filled with other people, you're interacting, you know, you're cheersing, you know, you're all listening to the same music, you're dancing, you know, you're vibing, you're having a great time. I just fell in love, and you know, it's been
it happens at the start, man. It happens at the start. The start, yo. What was the most craziest moment that you never thought would happen in VR chat?
So the craziest moment for me was listening to like all these big like producers and DJs, right? You know, like on Spotify and stuff like that. And then to get onto like the same lineups or even the same poster as those big DJs.
Like crazy, for example, DJs?
Like Fizzy.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, like 100%. Or fucking Two Tone or Iwamanius and all those guys. You know, it's insane. I would never have thought in a million years that I'd be on, even on just on the same poster, you know, even if I'm just the after party, just being on the same poster with them is insane to
it's
me,
like you feel
know?
That energy and just and like damn, feel proud of that shit.
Exactly. Yeah, you know, that shit would never happen in IRL, you know.
It would never. And like for this happening, it just goes to show you that VR is also like such a big, like I don't want, it's a different aspect of looking at life. And like damn, I thought I would never know that you're gonna be performing in front of like thousands of people in VR, you know. You never thought about that, and you're getting all these,
of course not.
You're growing as you go, you know. So what was the hardest moment of you being a DJ? Like what's the craziest, like there's been like struggles as a DJ in VR chat?
So obviously it comes with a lot of technical difficulties as a DJ in VR, right? So at a club, 7D, which is my main club that I DJ for, and I'm also staff there.
I was hosting an event
called Rhythm Council, which is, we had some of the biggest DJs around in the VRC community that play the hardest rhythm around, which is hence the name Rhythm Council.
Oh, hell yeah.
And I was on that lineup as well. And, you know, I was able to get on, and, you know, I played like maybe like two or three songs, and then my PC failed on me. And
my card had died.
And it was just hard for me because I had worked on that set for at least 2 to 3 weeks, you know. I'm so hyped for it. I've been talking about it for at least a month, you know. It's been planned since then. And you know, not being able to play that set that I had,
it really took,
you know,
a lot
made for
from
people to fuck. Exactly,
it really,
you know,
took
I was,
a
really
lot
looking
dude.
Forward to it. And you know, honestly, like, it just killed me.
Everybody hates it because we all want a perfect show. And that's what the hardest thing is, especially for in this game as well. Like, you are going through a stage of like not really caring about your music. Sometimes you're caring for the internet that is bringing your music to life. Maybe I'm wrong. Because you're putting so much dependability on that for internet to, or maybe your computer to be like, just like to freaking fail on you. And that just hits so hard to hear that, and it just like, it's a heartbreak, and you're like, dude, I think I'm never gonna DJ again. How many people were supporting you and stuff, or what happened?
So that day I had, in that instance at that time, I believe it was at least 60 to 70 people there.
Frick.
You know, which in VRC, that's a lot, right?
It is, you know, a lot. That is a lot.
In NDC, like between 30 to 20 people in an usual instance, you know, a normal public instance, you know. And, you know, and at least between half of those people were all people I knew very well, and people who actually enjoyed my stuff and knew who I was as a DJ, right?
Hell yeah.
And while the other half, that was their first time ever hearing me.
Dude.
You know, ever coming to my set. And,
frick.
You know, to, you know, see that, I was only able to play like 3 songs, and then I died midway. Was, I don't know what kind of impact I made, but I hope they'll ever come back to what about
Dude, they will. Just give it time, you know, just give it time. you're back at it now. You're gonna be better than ever. Like, what's giving you the motivation to come back at it?
So right now, I'm not on the best graphics card. No, I literally went to a pawn shop because I was like, I gotta do something. I gotta get back immediately. So I literally went to a pawn shop and I got lucky and I bought a 980, a GTX 980 for like $100. And thankfully it works good enough for me to get back into VR.
I feel that.
You know, it's like it's going like a jet right now, but it's working, I think. But my big supporters, in my opinion, are obviously the 7D crew, you know.
Oh, heck yeah. Much love for 7D, bro.
My homie Beagle, Fantex,
Hell yeah,
especially, Fantex. He's like one of the biggest inspirations to me because he's one of the guys, you know. He runs Phenocity and he's the one that's bringing all these big DJs, you know. He's the ones with all the connections to all these big Iroh DJs like Avaminius, Sizzy, Neonix, and you know, all of them. And to me, he's at the position I want to be at, you know. I want to be at his level. I want to be able to be on a, you know, friendly level with all those big DJs, you know. And,
oh yeah, imagine being friends, you know, with like your favorite DJ. Imagine being friends with your favorite DJ. That's the biggest thing we all want, is to be friends with a YouTuber, or friends with our like biggest YouTuber. And the craziest thing is that like this is here. You're literally talking to one of the biggest like crazy moments of your life that like you'll never expect. Like, damn, I'm actually talking to a really good DJ that might give me help and experience about a moment that like something. And turns out like you don't know this until like later, is that they are like one of the top DJs. And it's crazy to be like, damn, like what, like who am I talking to? It's just it's like it's a what the fuck moment every time I come into VR chat, bro. It's weird. But man,
especially like when I first met Muzz, you know. That was insane. Which, you know, he's a big Monster Cat DJ, right?
Dude.
Fucking big D&B Monster Cat DJ. Insane. Yeah. And for him to be able to come through and just do like a big virtual tour for free, like,
dude, it's
that would never happen. That would never happen.
Dude, it's the craziest thing, man, is that like who'd ever thought that this would ever happen in a million years? And it did. Mm-hmm. It happened in VR chat. And when the gross of VR chat is still going, the more people will come in and be like, dang, I want to go meet this person in VR chat, or this, like, I want to do this in VR chat. And trust me, it's only so much until, like, there's only so much you can do in VR chat until you get to the big, like, crazy events. You're going to be like, dude, this is like, I never thought I would ever meet my idol, or I would ever thought, like, it's just so crazy. That's all I'm saying. It's like the craziest things I've ever. I met people in this game where like, dang, like you have this many followers and you're here in this game doing what? Just chilling? Yeah, just socializing, bro. That's all. And to knowing about DJs and stuff, it's just crazy. Okay, I think the last two questions and then we should be good. These are crazy, man. These are really crazy. Let's see. We talked a lot on this one. I like this. I like this. I like this combo. If you had to see,
what
you
got for me?
If you, what is something that you truly have inspiration from this game, or just inspiration in general? Like, what do you have? What you got?
So my inspiration for this game, really, well, I mean, I wouldn't really consider this game. Honestly, at this point, I consider this a social platform, in my opinion. Mm-hmm. You know, but what I want to do is I just want to bring my music to people. You know, like I make a lot of metal stuff, so like I mix dubstep with metal.
Yes, metal you songs, really do.
And
yes,
that's what I really like to do. And you know, a lot of people, they've never heard that stuff. You know, they've heard dubstep, but have you ever heard like metal with dubstep, or even like rhythm with dubstep? Like
right you like, there's different varieties of different ways how you can make the music come alive, and that's what we all want.
Exactly. And you know, bringing my skill set as a DJ, doing that, you know, that really blows people away because it makes me stand out. You know, I'm not the best DJ in the world, right? I'm not the best one here in the whole community, you know. But I am one of the well-known ones in the community, I would say, at least.
Yeah, but, yeah, you get that. You give yourself that respect, and you understand, like, you're someone that's very talented and wants to give every moment of their life to giving a big inspiration for other people out there to be like, dang, Chris, like, you literally got my day to be better than what it was.
When I first joined, nobody was playing metal. You know, everyone was playing, you know, typical shit, you know, typical like dubstep, typical like house, bass, DMB and stuff like that. They're just playing, you know, the typical stuff that DJs play, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, I came on and, you know, I started playing my metal step and people were like, what the fuck was that? I've never heard that before. What is that? It's so fucking cool. I was like, yo, that's metal
cool.
step.
That's cool.
I was
cool.
like, it's just dubstep mixed with metal. That's all it is.
Right,
and I,
right,
yeah,
right,
that's
right.
fucking cool. I've never heard that. I've been in the community for this and that. I've never heard that. It's so fucking cool. You're so different. And then, so, you know, and then everyone keeps telling me, like it was after a couple of sets that I've already done, you know, of me just playing nothing but metal step, mm-hmm. right? And a couple of people were like, oh, you should do a set with Fetus Grinder. I was like, oh, Fetus Grinder, who's that?
Who's that?
And come to find out, Fetus Grinder is a very big, you know, another big individual in the VRC DJing community. He's
Dude.
Been DJing IRL for 23 years.
Dude.
This man can literally DJ for fucking hours on end, and he could play anything. And come to find out, he's one of the few that was also playing metal, you know, like straight metal, you know, metal
Dude,
step,
that
head
is...
step, all that heavy shit, right? And so we ended up getting him for a 7D lineup, which was called Mental with Metal, which featured me and Fetus Grinder both playing heavy metal sets, metal oriented sets. And ever since then, everyone's been playing a little bit of metal here and there. You know,
Dude,
they've had like a couple
you're giving
songs
that inspiration.
In their sets, and you know, like every DJ I've been to, I've heard just a slightly bit of metal. You know, like not the entire, but like I've been hearing it a lot more now. Cause used to
Dude.
I didn't used to hear none whatsoever. Now I'm starting to hear it here and there. You know, be playing some tracks that I've already played before.
Dude.
And, you know, and it. It's,
yes.
it makes me feel
Freaking,
good to
yes,
know that
dude.
I was part of that, you know?
And you know what? New things are coming the way to, like, being a better streamer, being a better, like, DJ, you know? And the biggest thing you could do is make new music. And that's what you did. You fucking made the new music. You made it come alive. And you know what? Like, that's something to be proud of, bro. Definitely have something on your wall mounted like that or something, like, taking photos, make it a world and shit, and like be like, yo, this is something I want to be inspired from. That's what everyone should know about, you know, and everyone should know that Chris here is one of the DJs I've ever fucking went crazy hard, a headbanger and shit. I've never had a headbanger. I'm telling you this right now, headbanger right here, dude. I got some clips in there where, dude, I was just every fucking time, bro. Telling you this, dude, is this guy is somebody unique. Please, everybody, give him a follow. Tell him, shout out your follows and stuff. What's your follows? What's your follows?
So,
your socials?
My Twitch is Chris _ DM.
You can do this.
And,
this stuff. Just like, kind of like, yeah, there you go. There you go.
Yeah. And then also my Twitter is also Chris DM, and the same thing with my Instagram, Chris DM
nice.
As well.
Nice.
You know, so just like to keep it simple.
Frick yeah, man. That's
yeah,
cool though.
So.
Yeah, dude. I'm gonna get real depth in this shit. Hey, I'm telling you this now, yo. This man has worked his butt off to get where he wanted to be at. Especially for what he's done, he's bringing a lot of his community to a better, like, better audience. And he's growing. He's worked his ass off. And his computer failed on him, but he found a way how he can grow himself to be a better DJ than what he is. And look at him now. He's definitely somebody that takes a lot of inspiration to this game. And for all of us out there that is looking for an opportunity to grow, especially to become a DJ, Chris is one of them to really have a friendship moment and a bond with. So everyone, please check out his stuff. everybody, much love. I hope to see you guys in the next podcast, or hear you guys in the next podcast, because your boy here is getting ready for a DJ set. So I'll see you guys later. Much love. I hope everyone is having a good night. Be safe, stay away from COVID. But let's try to see if we can get some good footage with the next set, okay? Next set coming out. So Chris, have you? So Chris, no, please, Chris, no, bro, no. Come on, Chris, we talked about this. Come on, bro. I was trying to get a good set. We didn't even finish our. Oh, damn it.